Good afternoon. Let's try that again. Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Pastor Latu. If I haven't introduced myself to, I apologize at the door. We are here to celebrate a great, magnificent woman. Friends, we have gathered here today to praise God and to witness to our faith as we celebrate the life of Suzan Hay. We come together in grief, acknowledging our human loss. May God grant us grace that in pain, we may find comfort in sorrow, hope, and in death resurrection. Let us pray. Dear Lord, we thank you for this opportunity to come together as family, friends, loved ones, affiliates. We are very grateful that you have given us an opportunity for today to have clear weather, to have plans to be open to fellowship and celebration of Suzan Hay. And so, Lord, we ask you to guide us with your Holy Spirit as we go on with our celebration of Suzan Hay and her family. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. I'd like to ask everyone, if you would look around your pew, there is a hymnal there. And if you are able, I'd like to ask all of you if you would stand, please, as we sing one of Susan's favorite hymns here in the Methodist Church. It is hymn number 110, and the name of the hymn is called "A Mighty Fortress Is Our God."
The words are also on the screen.
Yes, and the words are also on the screen.
Thank you.
Our scripture reading for today, my church family and friends, is taken out of the Gospel of Jesus Christ written by the Apostle Mark, chapter 11, verse 20 to 23. Mark chapter 11, verse 20 to verse 23. And this is how it's read. In the morning as they passed by, they saw the fig tree withered away to its roots. Then Peter remembered and said to him, "Rabbi, look, the fig tree that you cursed has withered." Jesus answered them, "Have faith in God. Truly I tell you, if you say to this mountain, 'Be taken up and thrown into the sea,' and if you do not doubt in your heart, but believe that what you will say come to pass, it will be done for you." At this time, I would like to ask the family for a time in share and remembrance.
Hello, everyone. Can you hear me?
Oh. Hello.
First off, I want to thank you all for being here today. Not only does it mean so much to myself and my family, but Mom would have been so happy to see all of you. Many of you know my name is Sarah, and Susan Hay was my most beloved mother. As I look back on the person my mother was and all that she accomplished, I struggle to find the words to adequately say goodbye. Susan was a loving wife and mother, kind-hearted friend, and a strong, brilliant woman. To know her was to love her, and I see proof of this as I look around this room today. If I could describe my mom in one word, it would be incomparable. As we look back on the past few years, it is easy to focus on the dementia that ultimately claimed her life. It was a cruel disease that altered much of who she was. However, those of you that met Mom in the last few years know that she still overflowed with love and kindness for all. Even in her darkest days, her beautiful soul could not be dimmed. When I sat down to write this remembrance, I realized that the last few years no longer matter. In the words of my father, she has been healed. Her suffering has ended. Instead, I urge that we all remember the wonderful days of her life, when she was carefree, unburdened, and happy. Much of Susan's life was characterized by her career in education. As one of the few high-ranking women in her field, Mom broke many glass ceilings and encouraged her students to reach for greatness in everything. After earning a PhD in education at USC, Susan joined the ranks of the tenured faculty at USC, eventually earning a spot as the chair of her department in the Herman Ostrow School of Dentistry. Susan was beloved by her colleagues and students and inspired many generations of dental healthcare professionals. Mom's determination and hard work ethic have been a constant inspiration for me throughout my life. Susan will be remembered as a brilliant woman that touched the lives of so many people. She was deeply loved by her family and friends. As a wife and mother, she was a confidant, partner, and protector. As a friend, she offered a shoulder to cry on, a loving embrace, and was a steadfast companion. For many of you, my mom was both friend and family. With her overwhelming sense of compassion and love, she always welcomed anyone she loved into our own extended family. Please know that we share in your grief, and just as Mom did, we still think of all of you as part of our big family. My father remembers my mother as a wonderful wife and mother. He cherishes the many happy years they spent together and will always remember her kind, loving heart. Although he mourns her deeply, he rejoices that she is free from pain and suffering. My husband remembers my mother as a kind and welcoming mother-in-law. Through her openness and warmth, he immediately felt part of the family, even after the first time they met. She radiated love and support, and without fail, was always his biggest fan. Amongst many things, he has fond memories of cooking with her during the holidays and watching UCLA and USC football games together. She will be forever missed, and he will continue to treasure those memories. Personally, I will always remember my mom as my best friend. She pushed me to follow my dreams and pursue a career in music. She was my confidant, cheerleader, and biggest fan. She attended every concert, rehearsal, and clarinet lesson when I was young and continued to support me into my adult life. My mom did everything for me, and I cannot thank her enough for raising me to be a strong, resilient woman just like her. Mom and I share a love of fishing, hiking, and exploring the ghost towns of the Eastern Sierra and Death Valley. She taught me how to fish, navigate the wilds, and stay out of questionable mine shafts. As a family, the three of us spent many years exploring the rugged and breathtaking landscapes of Eastern California and Nevada. These remain some of my most cherished memories. And I will miss my mom's silly jokes, USC Trojan pride, and infectious smile. I am honored and blessed to be her daughter, and I will do my best to honor her memory for the rest of my life. To you, Mom, I will never stop loving you, needing you, or missing you. You made such an impact in the lives of so many, and I am grateful for the time we had together. I know you will be with me for the rest of my days. So instead of goodbye, I will say, from a UCLA Bruin to a USC Trojan, fight on to victory one last time.
As we are going to our next segment, we are gonna witness a piece that's gonna be performed by Sarah and Eric Cal. I believe it's called Adagio, if that's the right pronunciation. I am not good with my European accent, but yes, a special performance by Sarah and Eric. Thank you. Thank you, Sarah. Thank you, Eric. That was beautiful. I've never heard anything like that before. But thank you for sharing that with us. Let us pray. Eternal God, we praise you for the great company of all those who have finished their course in faith and now rest from their labor. We praise you for those dear to us whom we name in our hearts before you. Especially we praise you for Suzan Hay, whom you have graciously received into your presence. To her family and friends, grant your peace to them. Let perpetual light shine upon them and help us to believe what we have not seen, that your presence may lead us through the coming years and remind us the joy of your home, not made with hands, but eternal in the heavens. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. A eulogy of Suzan Hay. On September 25th, 1947, Suzan was born, Suzan Lynch, to her adopted parents, Albert and Emma Lynch. She was raised in Long Beach, California, in which she enjoyed Southern California life under the sun and on the beach. She enjoyed cheering for the Jordan High Cheer Squad, fishing, camping, skiing, playing piccolo and flute, and spending time with her many friends. After high school, Suzan attended the University of Southern California, where she earned a bachelor's degree in dental hygiene. Suzan went on to graduate school to earn her master's degree and PhD in education from California State University, Long Beach, and USC. Her education was not the only thing that would ignite her success. She would proceed on, after earning her PhD, to chair her own department at the USC Herman Ostrow School of Dentistry, where she made great contributions to the fields of dentistry and dental hygiene. Her work and research in the oral health care field prepared the next generation to be educated, progressing to more opportunities in the future. Suzan broke barriers as the first woman to chair a department in the USC School of Dentistry. On January 18, 1990, Suzan married Ernest Hay. Also in January 1990, Suzan left her teaching and scholarly work at USC to pursue her new career as a mother to her only daughter, Sarah. She would fully depart from USC to spend more time with her family and to plan a new future in a new location. Eventually, the whole family moved to Moraga, California, and she began a new career as a professor of dental hygiene at Diablo Valley College. In 1996, Suzan, Ernest, and Sarah moved to Vacaville, California, where they started their own dental practice, working together as husband and wife. They built a strong foundation in connection with the community in pouring their talents of dentistry and business. As time collected, they sold their practice and moved to Gardnerville, Nevada. Suzan is remembered by her students to be passionate and brilliant, and a brilliant educator. She had so much love for the community and music, in which she joined many clubs and organizations in Vacaville and Gardnerville. From Seroptimus International to the Sierra Nevada Republican Women and the board of Sacramento Youth Symphony, her heart was formed to give her time to local schools and offer free college counseling to the younger generation. Suzan was received in God's hands on January 8, 2024. She is survived by her daughters, Sarah Hay Folick, and husband Ernest Hay, and son-in-law, Daniel Folick. She was an incredible person, full of love, laughter, and joy. She will be remembered as the best mother, wife, and friend. May we give a round of applause for Suzan Hay. Thank you. The grass withers, the flower fades, and the word of our Lord will be forever. In reflecting on the life of Suzan Hay, I would like to dispense a short message in our celebration of this magnificent woman, who was a mother, wife, friend, educator, barrier breaker, and an individual of the community. I bring a text that was read earlier of Mark chapter 11, verses 20 to 23, in which I wanted to focus on a certain scripture that is related to Suzan's work and presence on earth, and that is Mark chapter 11, verse 23, and it's read like this. Truly I tell you, if you say to this mountain, be taken up and thrown into the sea, and if you do not doubt in your heart, but believe that you will say it will come to pass, it will be done for you. My theme for today's celebration is called Moving Mountains with Faith. Moving Mountains with Faith. Before we had arrived today on this celebration, I met with Sarah and Ernest to talk about how we are going to organize today's memorial service. A question that I asked Sarah was, what scripture did Suzan love in the Bible? She mentioned something about moving mountains and trusting in the Lord. We were just brainstorming while I was reading Suzan's obituary of her accomplishments and outdoor lifestyle. I would say that this woman we are celebrating is a woman that moved mountains with faith. Three things I wanted to preach today about her is her life as a student, life as an accomplished scholar and educator, and a woman of virtue. In reflecting on her eulogy today, we can conclude as Suzan was passionate about her work in dentistry. I could imagine how much studying, time sacrificed with family and friends, and discipline needed to fulfill endeavors of the bachelor's, master's, and PhD program. Because the willpower to succeed is founded for a purpose. The drive, the energy, the compassion to assure her future, to provide for her family will be sown in her time in school. She succeeded in obtaining the credentials, but she wanted to do more than just be a student. Her learning phase evolved into a mindset to provide for the future of dental hygiene studies and alongside becoming involved in the community. We know that the family did some moving from Los Angeles to the Bay Area and on to Northern Nevada, from transitioning from a student to dispensing her knowledge of becoming a chairwoman for the USC Herman Ostro School of Dentistry, to becoming a professor, to opening her own practice with Ernest. We can say these were mountains moved in order to share her gift with others in the coming future. Now, beloved, it is one thing to climb a mountain. Climbing a mountain, getting over the top to the other side of the mountain. However, the mountain, after you have climbed over the top to the other side, is still standing between you and the other side. Now, reflecting on today's gospel, if you're moving the mountain, you are extracting it completely so that no one would have to struggle in climbing, but the path is clear for the next person who wants to walk in the same path. This is what faith is all about. This is what Jesus Christ, the Jesus that you and I hear about every day, that he took our sins to the cross so that we are not in suffering anymore, that those who believe in him will have eternal life. For Suzan, she cleared mountains, throwing it in the sea, symbolically, using her gifts as a student and as an educator to become a person of virtue for the community. She cleared the mountains for the future of those who want to pursue a career in dentistry and dental hygiene and many, many, many more. It is paving a path so that the next person will not have to climb the same struggle or the same mountain, but walk in faith to succeed in their educational and professional goals. To not only be available to male, female, or person of color, but to all. Suzan cleared the path for an important reason in her life that was beyond her career and her education. She also cleared the mountains to prioritize a pathway of time as a mother to Sarah and wife to Ernest. This is a faith-driven woman. She took care of people in her community, and she took care of her own family. This is an honorable act that glorifies God, to love God with all your might and soul, and to love your neighbor as you love yourself. It is an act of faith for people who trust in the Lord, bringing our gifts to replenish this wicked world that you and I live in every day, to replenish this world with opportunity, is one of the ways we follow Jesus to thrive in our communities and to heal the world that you and I live in. As a Christian, Suzan understood what Jesus had done on the cross. Her cross was the servitude to the community. Her cross was preparing the students of the future and to devote her time to her family. Her faith is similar in her life story, that all the time in the classroom, her own practice and organization was to bring light into an undeserving world. May she go into God's hands. As we live under his presence, may this teach us to move mountains and to trust in the Lord while we're doing it. A quote that Suzan loved to end my sermon is from the philosopher John Muir, which says, "The mountains are calling. I must go." The mountains are calling. I must go. Suzan, you go now. We will wait our time when it's time for us to go. And these are one of the things that we spoke about as we were trying to organize for today, is that as a Christian believer, we do not believe that death exists. We only speak life. I told Sarah, if you're a Christian believer, death is like a doorway to the next location. You are changing location. I think of it as if you ever flew a plane, if you ever went on a plane or boarded to a long trip, the only way to get into the plane is through the ramp. And that's my symbolism to how you get to the other location. You have to go through that ramp in order for you to get to that next location. So Suzan, we forbid you farewell. You left a mark in our lives. Even though I have not met you, Suzan, but your story has formed my pastoring. And this is my first memorial that I've ever conducted. So Sarah, Ernest, and Daniel, thank you for this opportunity. Also friends and family. I ask you to go in peace, to not hurt, but to love one another, to go with a piece of Suzan with you, to your homes, because it has impacted each and one of you today in this holy sanctuary. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I'd like to ask Sarah and Eric to perform our closing hymn. Thank you. Thank you. Before I say closing benediction, I would like to invite you all to the fellowship hall for the wake. But I'd like to ask the family if you let the family go in first, so that they can greet you while you go in there. And we will go on from there. Let us say benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.